Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Maths Club Easy Learning. I'm Professor Deepanjan Kumar De. Today I will deliver another important lecture on data communication and networking. The topic is token passing. That is, in this session the learner will be able to know the control access protocol token passing. Okay. And number two, the understand the performance of token passing. And number three, the advantage and disadvantage of token passing. These are the outcomes of this session. Token passing. So let's start. First, control access protocol. Just I am telling what is control access protocol, because I already discussed control access protocol in my previous video. So what is control access protocol? That is, station consult one another, or stations, or you can say devices consult one another. That is, station will be decide with themselves which stations would send data. That is, in control access protocol, station consult one another to find which station has to write to send. A station cannot send unless it has been authorized by other station. That means, when a station wants to send a data, he will consult with other stations that who will send the data. That is, among themselves they will consult with each other. The control access protocol are the following three categories, that is reservation, polling and token passing. Reservation and polling already I discussed in my previous videos. You can check my YouTube channel Maths Club. Now token passing. So token passing, it is control access protocol. In token passing, what is token? Token is like a ticket. Token is like a ticket. That is, if you have a ticket, then you can travel. In this case, you can send data. That means, token is like a ticket. If you have a ticket, then you can travel. In this case, you can send data. In a token ring network, all host or work stations are connected in a ring topology. That is, number one, in token ring network, all stations are connected in a ring topology. This is a ring topology. These are the stations: station 1, station 2, station 3, station 4, station 5. These are the stations, okay, in a ring topology. Okay, so a station authorized to send data. Point number 2, a station is authorized to send data when it receives a special frame, a special frame called token. The token and empty frame. Token is known as a token and empty and empty a token and empty an empty frame. Empty frame is continuously circulated on the ring. That means the token is always circulated on the ring. That is empty token. That is the token, empty token, always circulated, continuously circulated on the ring. That is, this is the ring. Token is continuously circulated on the ring. Okay. Next, point number three. It is unidirectional. That is, token will circulate unidirectionally. Token it is unidirectional, not bidirectional. Means either token will be in clockwise or in token will circulate either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction, not in both direction. Okay, token will circulate either in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So it is called unidirectional, not bidirectional. Number four. When a node receives a token, suppose when a node receives a token, it holds onto the token only. It holds onto the token only if it has some frame to transmit. If it has some frame to transmit. Okay. Otherwise, it immediately forwards the token to the next node. That is successor to the next node. Each station has a predecessor and a successor. successor. That means every station, suppose this is a station, this has a predecessor and a successor. This is suppose current station. So before predecessor means previous station, successor means next station. Suppose this is current station, so this station is predecessor, this is known as successor. So this is the current node, this is predecessor, this is successor. So every station has, suppose this is for this station, this will be predecessor, this will be successor. Okay, so we can say every station has a successor and a predecessor. So this point, once again I am discussing, when a node receives a token, it holds onto the token only. That means a station holds the token only if it has some frame to transmit. Otherwise it will send to the next node. Okay, if it does not transmit data, then it will, then every station will send the token to the next station. If any station wants to send data, he will hold the token, otherwise he will immediately forward the token to the next node. So every station has a predecessor and a successor. Okay, predecessor means before, successor means after. Suppose now what is happening, how does it work actually, token passing, how does it work? Suppose a current station S1 has a message to send the work station S4. That is, S1 is a source address, S4 is the destination address. S1 is the source address, S1 wants to send data to S4, to send work station S4, that is destination. Then S1 catches the token, because S1 is sending data, S1 catches the token from the predecessor, that is from, this is the predecessor, from the predecessor, that is S2, from S2 he will catch the token and then attach the data which one he has to send the data to S4, and attach its data, and then the attach its data. When data attached to the empty token, then empty token becomes a data frame. Then the station release the token back to the ring, that is to station 5, that is the successor. After holding a token from the predecessor, S1 will send data, the data will attach to the token and then it send to the next station, that is the successor, that is to S5. Now S5 will check, when S5 received that data frame from S1, now S5 will check the destination address. now S5 will check the destination address. Destination address, whether the data is for him or not, whether the data is for him or not. That means when S5 received a data frame from S1, then S5 will check the destination address whether the data is for him or not. Him or not. If the data is not for him, if the data is not for him, if the data is not for him, then S5 passes the token to the next station, that is next station is S4, that is to S4. S4 is the destination address. S4 is the destination address. So S4 will get the data from S1 by this way. So this is the process. This is the process that data reaches the destination. The destination address. After taking data, S4 send free token to next station S3, because when S4 gets data, he will take the data and the token will free from data. After taking data, S4 sends the free token to the next station S3. That means when the data takes S4, then the token becomes free of data. Then S4 sends that free token to the next immediate station, that is S3. By this way, the data reaches the destination address from source address. So these are the mechanism of token passing system. There are some advantages and disadvantages of token passing system. I am discussing here some advantages. Token passing method is highly efficient. Token passing method is highly efficient. That is, possibility of collision is very low. That is possibility of collision is very low. So there is no chances for collision. Possibility of collision is very low. So that means you can rely this token passing system. So some disadvantages are there. It has some problem it has some problem. For example, it has some problem. It has some problem. It has some problem. For example, the failure of one node, the failure of one node can crash the entire channel. So these are the disadvantages. Another disadvantage I can say, if a node accidentally neglects, if a node accidentally neglects to release the token, what happens? The other station will be waiting definitely for this token. Again, this is another problem. If a node accidentally neglects to release token, accidentally means suppose the software is crashing, then accidentally neglects to release the token, it means deliberately if a station holding a token for a long time, then there will be a problem other stations, because other stations will be waiting definitely for the token. Again, this is a problem. This is another problem. Okay, this is another disadvantages of token passing system. Okay, so I think you understand very nicely token passing system. What is token passing system? I already discussed very nicely the mechanism of token passing system. So how does it work? I have discussed very nicely. Again, I'm just giving the highlights. Suppose S1 wants to send data to S4, then S1 will take a empty token from the predecessor, from S2. Then after receive the empty token, S1 receive empty token, then it will attach the data, then it send it to next station, that is S5, that is the successor. Then S5 receives the token, S5 will check the destination address, if it is, whether the data is for him or not. If it is not for him, then S5 will send that frame, send the token to the next station, that is S4. But we know S4 is the destination address. By this way, the destination address gets data from source address. So this is the mechanism. This is how token passing system works nicely. Okay. So the control access protocol, I have finished here. There are three types of control access protocol: reservation, polling, and token passing. So next I will come with new videos on data communication and networking. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you very much.